To this video introducing automatic flight control systems. This video will pave the way for a series of videos where we will implement some of the concepts relating to automatic flight control systems. Today we will talk about stability augmentation systems, control augmentation systems, and we will finish by autopilots, modern autopilots. Historically, stability augmentation systems came first as a necessity to provide pilots with an aircraft having better handling qualities. They achieved this by improving dynamic stability. Dynamic stability requirements for civil aviation aircraft are governed by rules issued by aviation authorities. For example, CFR 14 for the FAA, Part 25 for large aircrafts, Parts also 23, 27, 29. The same goes for EASA in the European Union with design specification, conception specification, Parts 25, 23, 27, 29. SAS are used to comply with these requirements. They are also used on some military aircrafts that are inflyable without SAS, like aircrafts of class 4 in the military specification MIL F8785. They are also used to reduce pilot workload in helicopters, as helicopter piloting requires constant control inputs using both hands and both feet. Dynamic stability is achieved in SAS by using feedback control and control input to the and proposing control inputs to pilot's commands. Some examples of SAS include axis dampers like yaw damper, roll damper, and pitch damper. The most famous of these is the yaw damper, which is used on most commercial aircraft to improve Dutch roll characteristics. The roll damper is used to improve roll mode oscillations, for example, on the X-15 experimental aircraft. Pitch damper is used to improve the short period oscillation mode. As for control augmentation system, it came as a natural evolution from stability augmentation systems to solve a particular problem encountered with these. In fact, stability augmentation system controllers were issuing commands that oppose pilots' inputs. To prevent that, CAS adopted the same architecture as SAS, but added an all-electric input control that can't be opposed. Control augmentation and stability augmentation are used in conjunction. Thus, those systems are called control and stability augmentation systems, CSAS. Finally, modern autopilots are devices that can perform a broad range of tasks aiming to reduce pilot workload. It communicates with multiple systems as FMS, ILS, GPS, etc. The interface differs from manufacturer to manufacturer, but in principle, autopilots incorporate inner loops that are in a sense similar to control and stability augmentation systems, like the yaw damper, pitch damper, roll damper, but also angle of attack feedback and load factor feedback. In addition to that, autopilots provide also outer loops functions such as airspeed hold, pitch altitude hold, bank angle hold, heading hold, etc. That was all for today. Thank you for watching.